Then it uses a set of closure assumptions that relate the parameterized process to the state of the atmosphere. The parameterization schemes have the largest impact on the prediction of the sensible weather at the Earth's surface, Pelkey, 2002. These schemes became more complex over time and interact with each other, the numerical and dynamical parts of the model. Model diagnostics produces the numerical values of the sensible weather fields from the model variables, such as the accumulated precipitation, instantaneous cloudiness or maximum wind gusts. Wind, temperature and humidity are interpolated from the model levels to the standard meteorological measurement heights, 10 and 2 meters above surface, using a parameterized profile, Jelen, 1988. The Croatian mountains are relatively small in extent. Many of them have width close to 10 kilometers and length less than 50 kilometers. But the mountain peaks reach over 1 kilometer inland, and several mountain tops reach over 1.5 kilometers very close to the coastline, Fig. 3. These mountains are separated by deep and inhabited valleys while important roads and connections go through the mountain passes. Weather in Croatia is in many ways modified or even controlled by orography, Zaninovic et al. 2008. But the large-scale models do not resolve many of these local weather patterns. These weather patterns result from interaction of synoptic forcing with orography. Improved representation of orography in a meteorological model is expected to improve the forecast of weather phenomena that are strongly influenced by local orography, Horvath et al., 2011, Bajic, 2007, Brankovic et al., 2008. In wind forecast with 8 kilometers, A, and 2 km resolution, B, for 6 at 5th of February 2003. The dynamical adaptation method of Zagar and Rakovec, 1999, has been adapted for the purpose of operational forecast of the 10 meters wind. The method provided successful operational forecast of the 10 meters wind, Ivatek, Sodden and Tudor, 2004, and has been used extensively in research impact studies, Bajic et al., 2007. As well as case studies, Tudor and Ivatek Sodden, 2002, of severe wind. The meteorological model fields are first interpolated from the low resolution, 8 km in this case, to a higher resolution, 2 km, grid, but on considerably lower number of model levels, from 37 to 15 levels in the vertical. The number of vertical levels is reduced to minimize the computational cost. The levels close to the ground are of similar density, but the levels higher in the atmosphere are mostly emitted. Then a hydrostatic version of the Aladdin model is run for 30 time steps with a 60 seconds time step. The same large-scale model data is used for the initial and LBC data, therefore the fields on the lateral boundaries do not change during the adaptation procedure. Turbulence is the only parameterization scheme used. Contributions from the moist and radiation processes are not computed to accelerate the model run. Vertical cross-section of wind speed, shaded, direction, vectors, and potential temperature, black isolines, for 6 at 5th of February 2003. HRDA improves 10 meters wind forecast, by 15%, especially in weather situation with strong Bora wind, since wind speed and direction depend on the terrain configuration upstream. Figure 7a and 7b illustrates the impact of high-resolution orography on the 10 meters wind forecast. HRDA wind is much weaker, reduces from 10 to 15 meters per second to less than 5 meters per second, and changes the direction, up to 180 degrees, depending on location, from the low resolution forecast in the valley upstream of the mountain. Downstream of the mountain, wind is much stronger, increases from 15 meters per second in low resolution model to more than 30 meters per second, in the high resolution model run as mountain wave breaks and windstorm reaches the mountain slope, Fig. 8. The 10 meters wind forecast from HRDA has been used in several applications, and improved the safety of the traffic in the air, on the sea as well as on land. Unfortunately, there were also events of short Bora episodes connected to a local pressure disturbance, Tudor and Ivatek Sodden, 2010, that were not predicted by HRDA. These were used in a further study to assess the impact of the neglected effects to these Bora episodes. This procedure is able to forecast Bora onset, duration and strength if it is a consequence of a synoptic forcing. It misses those cases initiated by small-scale disturbances in the pressure fields. These disturbances have to be modeled first, using the non-hydrostatic model version on more levels in the vertical with full complexity of the physical parameterization package. These conclusions were based on analysis of a number of cases of BURA associated with a small-scale pressure disturbance. Once a pressure disturbance is modeled, the wind field acts according to the measurements. The disturbances have to be detected first in the pressure measurements from the automatic stations that are performed on a less dense network than the wind measurements. The operational forecast using the latter configuration has been established only recently. The number of cases is still too short to make a thorough statistical analysis. In CMHS, the operational Aladeen forecast is run twice per day, starting from 00 and 12 o'clock analyzes. The operational Aladeen model forecast is run 72 hours in advance on a Lambert projection domain with 8 km horizontal resolution on 37 hybrid sigma pressure levels in the vertical. The model fields are subsequently going through a dynamical adaptation procedure, Ivatek Sodden and Tudor, 2004, that produces 2 km resolution forecast of 10 meters wind speed and gusts. There are two more sets of initial and LBC data available from both RPEJ and IFS. The analyses at 06 and 18 UK are used for cycling of the data assimilation procedure. Only 6-hour forecasts are produced from these analyses and they are used as a first guess in the data assimilation procedure for the next analysis time, 12 and 00 UK, that initiates the 72-hour forecast. Alternative 8 km resolution 72 hours forecast run from the initial fields created in 00 and 12 UK data assimilation. These runs provide an alternative forecast fields that differ slightly from the first operational run. As an addition to the operational forecast, 2 km resolution 24-hour forecast was established recently, that uses the non-hydrostatic, NH, dynamics in the Aladeen model and the Aladeen's full parameterization set, including the convection scheme. This forecast runs is performed once per day, following the 00 UK operational 8 km resolution forecast. It uses the 6-hour forecast from the 8 km resolution operational run as input initial file and runs with STI. This high-resolution forecast is run for 24 hours, until 6 UK on the next day. This procedure allows covering the 24-hour period used to collect precipitation data from the rain gauges. High-impact weather events are often forecasted by means of their predictability. Aladeen has been used in several predictability studies, for example Brankovic et al., 2007, as well as the Limited Area Ensemble Forecasting, Wang et al., 2011, system. In most of these studies, IKIM WF ensemble forecasts were dynamically downscaled for several severe weather cases. Therefore, the initial conditions come from perturbations generated by singular vectors of IKIM WF. Wang et al. 2011, combined different initial and boundary conditions from the perturbed global model with other aspects of forecast uncertainty, such as blending, multiphysics approach and breeding. Predictability studies of BURA cases have found little sensitivity to different initial conditions, Ivatek Sodden and Ivankin Pichek, 2006. Horvath et al. 2009, suggested a small effect of uncertainties in the upstream initial conditions on the BURA events in the southern Adriatic Sea. Another study of severe BURA, Brankovic et al., 2007, exemplified a case of gale force BURA that was predicted with a probability exceeding 95%. Dynamical downscaling of IKIM WF fields from 40 to 8 km resolution improves the precipitation rate and pattern in the intensive precipitation cases, Brankovic et al., 2008, 2, the predicted precipitation is roughly double in the high-resolution forecasts, but still reaches only 20% of the observed precipitation maximum.